Okay, so my next video is 10 Friends by Bruce Goldstone, and the illustrations were by Heather Cahoon. If you could ask 10 friends to tea, tell me who your friends would be. Would you want 10 firefighters to save you all from danger? Or how about 9 grizzly bears and 1 friendly forest ranger? If you asked trusty tailors, they could come with 2 proud plumbers. Or 7 salty sailors could munch with 3 loud drummers. You might find 6 ballerinas and frogs who love to leap, and 4 frogs who love to leap, sorry. Or will you ask 5 shepherds and fleecy, fluffy sheep? So, this book is all about different ways to get to 10, which I think is really awesome. So this is a counting book because it goes from 1 to 10, and it has the number of objects on the page. I lost my train of thought there. So it has 9 grizzly bears. It has 1 forest ranger, and it had the 8 mice. Were they mice? Trusty tailors. And it had 8 of those, 2 of the elephants, that kind of thing. So for development, this would be, I think on some level, social. To show that you can have 10 friends, but they can be all sorts of friends. You can bring them in all sorts of ways, different kind of things, cognitive, as always, always, and he's moving, always, we're always building up prior knowledge, creating new knowledge. I think everything I've said in all the other videos, everything falls into cognitive. I will always say it's cognitive because it's always teaching. For literary, so there are some alliterations in here. And I thought that was interesting. So, for example, 8 trusty tailors, 2 proud plumbers, 7 salty sailors. There's another one in here. Fleecy, fluffy sheep. So really teaching those alliterations, which is the repetition of consonant sounds. 2 teachers, 2 trolls, and 2 tycoons. So I think, so for a lesson plan, I would honestly kind of roll these in together. For both aspects, it won't be 2 separate activities, it would kind of all be in one. So the first one to do with development, with that cognitive and social and all that, my students would have to write a story. I really like writing. I really like reading stories. They would have to write a story about how they would bring different friends. So you have to bring 10 friends. They can't all 10 be the same friends. So I'd like to see a different way of how they make it to 10. So do they bring 5 hippos and 3 dinosaurs and 2 mice? How in their head do they get to 10? And that's what I would want to see. I want to be able to see that they can think through their head or think through and think, okay, this is how I get to 10 in different ways. To pull that in with literary, since there are alliterations, which we would discuss, they would have to include alliterations in their story. So 2 of the people they bring, if they are hungry hippos, if they are munching mice, it doesn't matter. I want to see those alliterations in your story. I want to see why you chose to invite them, how many you chose to invite, and there'd be different guidelines with that. But I think letting them express themselves through writing is so important. I know I, as a student, when I was a younger student, I loved when I got to write stories about different things. And sometimes it almost helped those concepts click a little bit more for me because I got to write them out. And I'm creative on some level. And so I think that feeds, while we have our students that do so well visually, we have our students who also do well when they physically write things down. And so I think that helps those students just as much as visual students because they're going to read through the story. So those are my lesson plans. It's a little bit about the book. I think it's a really good one for beginning to teach math.